There is Bhagavad Gita, but people could not understand Krishna. Now we are presenting Krishna as it is. People are understanding, they are becoming devotees. So we have to go through the right channel, then he'll know Krishna. And as soon as you know Krishna as he is, your life is successful. That is the aim and object of Krishna consciousness movement. Simply to help the people to know Krishna. This is all you. Because as soon as you know Krishna, your life is successful. In which way? Success is takta dehang punarjanma naiti. This is success. This body should be the last acceptance of material body. That is success. Otherwise, if you continue tatha dehantara prati, these foolish people, they do not know that dehantara, there is change of body. Change of body is there already, we are experiencing. But they do not believe that after death there is body. Why not? If we have got experience in this life, I have passed through so many changes of body, from babyhood to childhood, childhood to boyhood, boyhood to youthhood, then middle age and old body, then what is next? Why do you finish here? It is common logic. Why should you finish here? There must be body. This is real reasoning. And Krishna confirms it. Not only your contemplation, Krishna says, tatha dehantara prapti. In this way, we'll have another body. Krishna, the great authority, he says, from whom Brahma, the first creature, he learned, tene brahma rida adikavai. Krishna Vasudeva, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. He tene brahma rida adikavai. He taught this basic literature to the heart of Brahma. He can teach you through the heart also, because he is sitting there, Ishvara Sarva Bhutana. Riddhese, a particular mention, Riddhese, within the core of the heart. He doesn't say that Ishvara is situated on your finger. No, within the heart. The particular place is mentioned. Therefore, the yogis practice, real yoga practice means to find out Krishna within the heart. That is real yoga. Dhyanavastita tadgatena manasa pasyanti yam yogina. This is yogi. Yogi is meditate. What for meditation? To find out Krishna within the heart. That is yogi. Not to show magic and gymnastics. No, that is not. That gymnastic yoga, that is not yoga. Real yoga is to find out Krishna within one's own heart. Premanjana Charita Bhakti. That yoga means you have to come to the platform of prema, love. Not that simply official practice you can see. You have to come to the platform without having love connection with Krishna. It is not possible. You may practice this hatha yoga or gymnastic yoga for many, many births. You cannot see Krishna. Krishna can be seen when you smear with love ointment in your eyes. Premanjana Charita Bhakti Vyojanena. And that is possible bhakti, through bhakti. So therefore, why not practice bhakti yoga from the beginning if you want to see Krishna? And that is recommended by Krishna. Yoginam api sarvesam madgata antaratmana sadhyavan bhajate juma samayukta tamo. Krishna says he is first class yogi. who is always trying to see Krishna within the heart. So it is very difficult task. In our bhakti yoga, we can teach this art of seeing Krishna within the core of the heart in 1 minute. It is so simple. You are seeing Krishna here. You must have impression and try to keep that impression within your heart, always. Then you become first class yogi. Why so much gymnastics? I'm pressing the nose. No. Take directly. If you are engaged 24 hours in the service of the deity, you cannot see except the deity. This bhakti yoga practice is so simple. Therefore, Kanishtadhikari, those who are neophytic, they must take to deity worship. By deity worship, he is elevated to the position of seeing the Lord within the heart. This is very important thing. You can see He is there, but you have no knowledge, or even if you have knowledge, you are not competent to see it. But if you practice deity worship, therefore it is the duty of Guru to engage the neophyte devotee always in deity worship. Sri Vigrahara Dhana Nityanana Singharathana Mandiramadana Jiktascha Bhaktangsa Nijanjatopi Bandi Gurasri Charanam. It is the duty of the Guru to engage his disciples in deity worship, in cleansing the temple, dressing the deity, decorating the deity, so many engagements. So everyone should be engaged. If one is not competent to dress the deity, everyone is competent. He can simply wash the temple and cleanse it. That will also. There is no difference that one who is cleansing the floor of the temple and one who is engaged directly in the deity worship, there is no difference. They are all the same. Don't think that I am engaged in cleansing the floor of the temple and he is engaged in decorating the temple. I should be envious. No, there is no question. Any kind of duty you are engaged, sakarmana tamabhach. If you cannot do something which is hard for you, you do anything for Krishna under the direction of spiritual master, you get perfect. It is not that I have to do this, I have to do that. No, Krishna's service is manifold. If one is unable to take one kind of service, the spiritual master can give him another kind of service. But both the services are accepted by Krishna. Thank you very much.